Mother Earth is sick, just like us, who occasionally would catch a cold, have a sore throat, or even get a sinus infection. Mother Earth also got sick. Except, in this case, the parasite causing it are us, human. Although our day-to-day action might not be a direct reason the Earth is dying, but there are other things we are responsible for that should be taken into account. With the growing population of 1 billion in every decade, it is predicted that the world energy demand from the year 2005 to the year 2030 will expand by 55%. The increasing number of people and their standard of living in developing countries such as China and India is believed to place even more demand on energy. In the last two decades, 59% electricity generation in Indonesia still relied on coal as the fuel source. Coal remained the best option because it is economical and abundant. But for every kWh generated from coal, 1.183 kg of carbon dioxide is produced. As a result, coal-fired electricity generation accounted for 30% of global carbon dioxide emission. Studies found that carbon dioxide emitted from coal combustion is responsible for over 0.3 degrees Celsius of the 1 degree Celsius increase in global average annual surface temperature. But don't worry, renewable energy has grown in the last few years, with one of them being utilization of biomass waste. Biomass is organic material that comes from plants and animals, and it is a renewable source of energy. One of the most potential biomasses in Indonesia is empty palm fruit bunch, or EPB, which is a waste produced from palm oil industry. In 2018 alone, 16 million tons of EPB is produced in Indonesia. When EPB is converted into biocoal, it could be a desirable alternative fuel source. To produce EPB biocoal, EPB goes through a slow pyrolysis process that is also called torrefaction, which carried out in the absence of oxygen. The process started by pre-drying EPB using hot air in rotary dryer, which gave a positive impact on reduction of EPB moisture content and increased the pyrolysis efficiency. Then the bright EPB goes to a fixed bed reactor where the following full processes take place. Biomass is pyrolyzed at 300 degrees Celsius until 400 degrees Celsius, producing biocoal while removing the volatile particles. By pyrolyzing in high temperature, it raises elemental carbon concentration, disappearance of fiber structure, and improved grindability. The biocoal produced is then cooled to the ambient temperature, while the byproduct exits as gas and ash. The product has a calorific value in the range of 20 to 30 megajoules per kilogram, which is equivalent to Lourenco calorific value. Biocoal is produced at $77.8 per ton, while coal is priced at $72.1 per ton. Biocoal utilization in power plant also creates more jobs. In Straw study, power plant that use 90% coal and 10% biocoal as feedstock create additional 71 more jobs than conventional coal power plant. Other alternative use of biocoal is for soil fertilizer and activated carbon. Biocoal as soil fertilizer is also called biochar. Biochar can increase cation exchange capacity and pH of soil, thus increasing soil moisture, decrease the emission of nitrous oxide, and promotes root development. Biocoal, when turned into activated carbon, allows absorption materials in their liquid and gas phase, which can be used in many industrial sectors. In general, the utilization of EPB into biocoal benefits the environment in many aspects. First, by utilizing palm oil industry waste, methane emission from landfill could be reduced, and the necessity of seeking alternative methods on waste management can be cut down. Second, if biocoal is used in power plant, carbon dioxide release will be decreased since carbon content in EPB typically less than coal. In addition, the carbon dioxide produced from biocoal combustion can be considered as carbon dioxide neutral. Considering the Sustainable Development Project from the UN, don't you think by using biocoal as fuel alternative, we can prevent the Earth from suffering?